Hey everyone, I hope you're having a wonderful day because your happiness is my happiness. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get NAT Type 1 on PS4, PS5, Xbox and Nintendo Switch. With this method, you will get NAT Type 1 on PlayStation, NAT Type Open on Xbox and NAT Type A on Nintendo Switch. There are two ways to get NAT Type 1 in any gaming console that you have. The first method is how to get NAT Type 1 with a LAN cable, and the second one is how to get NAT Type 1 with Wi-Fi. And that's true, you can get NAT Type 1 even with Wi-Fi. I'm so interested about it, let's get it started. Step 1, connection type. This is the most important part. If you are using a 4G, 5G, LTE or any kind of mobile connections, you can't get NAT Type 1. And if you want to know what NAT Type is exactly, check this video from here or link in the description below. What you need to get NAT Type 1 is a home connection like ADSL, VDSL, fiber, wireless connection that they give you, a router that you use in your house to connect to the internet. If you are using mobile connection, you can't get NAT Type 1. Currently, I'm using ADSL 2 Plus for gaming and it works fine with NAT Type 1. So if you have any kind of house connections with a router, you can follow the steps to get NAT Type 1 as well. Warning, if you use NAT Type 1, only one device can be connected to the internet at a time. It means if you want to use it for your gaming console, only your gaming console can be connected to the internet. I will make another video how to get NAT Type open on any game without NAT Type 1. It means you have NAT Type 2, but your NAT Type in any game is open, okay? Step 2, router settings. This is where our journey starts. First of all, you need to find your router IP address for these settings. There are two ways to find it. First, you can go to your phone or PlayStation settings and find gateway when you are connected to the router. You can see gateway in my console, also in my phone. For most of routers, it's 192.168.1.1 or 192.168.0.1. If you couldn't find it, you can search your router model in Google to find the IP address. After that, when you enter IP address in any browser, it will ask you for username and password. It is admin by default for most of the routers, but if you can't find it, you need to search in Google again. Depend on your router brand, first of all, go to status and find the PVC that is active. For me, it's PVC2. Then go to interface setup or other settings where you can find internet settings. In this TP-Link router, it's here, but for your router, you can check website or Google if you can't find it. So here I need to choose PVC2 to get access to settings. As you can see, there is a username and password which your ISP, internet service provider, gave you to use it in your router. If you don't remember your username and password or you can't see it in your router, don't worry at all. You can call your ISP anytime and ask for your username and your password, because we will need it later in your gaming console. Then what you need to change in your router settings is ISP mode. Don't change it now, because if you change it, you can't continue watching this video. Make sure that you have any kind of connection that you can use on your phone, like your SIM card 4G connection, because when you wanna do this tutorial, you need an internet connection, and when you change your router settings, your connection to the internet will be disconnected. So make sure that you have a connection on your phone, like SIM card connection, and then you can change router settings. What you need to do here is to change it to bridge mode, then save the settings, wait for a few seconds, like 10 seconds, and after that restart your router. That's it, so easy. You also need to wait until connection icon turns on in your router. It may take 2 minutes, then we can go to the next step, which is setting up your PS4, PS5, Xbox or Nintendo Switch for NAT Type 1. Step 3, set up your console. If you haven't got username and password from your ISP, now it's the time to call them and ask your username and password that they did use in your router, because you need it here. I'm going to show you how do I do this on my PS4, but with a little bit expert, you can do this on any gaming console that you have. It is so easy. I told you there are two ways to do this, right? So let's go with the first one. How to get NAT Type 1 on any gaming console with a LAN cable. Connect your console to your router with a LAN cable. Then you need to go to Settings, Network, Setup Internet Connection, Use a LAN Cable. Then choose Custom. This part might be different in Nintendo Switch, Xbox, Steam Deck or any other kind of gaming console that you are using. So you need to go to Network Settings and find similar settings to what I'm using right now. In IP address settings, choose PPPoE. Now you need your username and password from your ISP, which I told you, please remember it or call the support. Then for DNS and any other settings, you can select the default option. Test your internet connection. It may fail once after you set up the connection because it might get some issues for the first try. But try once again and there we have it. You can see NAT Type 1 on your console and testing connection is successful. If you non-stop getting this error, it might be because your username or password is wrong. Okay, now let's try the second method. NAT Type 1 on your console with Wi-Fi. Make sure your router Wi-Fi is on. Then in your console, select Use Wi-Fi instead of LAN. If you have some setting from past, select No. Then select Custom. Select your router and enter Wi-Fi password, not your ISP password, only your Wi-Fi password, okay? Then you will see PPPoE option again. Enter username and password from your ISP. You can call the support and ask them to get your username and password. After that, select default settings for the rest of the settings, and if you did everything right, it will show you NAT Type 1 on PlayStation or NAT Type Open on Xbox or NAT Type A on Nintendo Switch. If it failed for a few times, you need to make sure that you have the correct username and password. Step number 4, still can't get NAT Type 1. If you still can't get NAT Type 1 or Open or A on your gaming console, you need to call your ISP. If it's 2 or 3, there might be some issues from them. You can tell them, I did use bridge mode, but I still have NAT Type 2 or 3. And by the way, next video will be how to get NAT Type open on any game without having NAT Type 1. You can have NAT Type open with NAT Type 2 on any game. If you have NAT Type 3 and your ISP can't fix it, they tell you, for example, we can't fix your NAT Type, you can check this video from here. I did make this video for you how to fix NAT Type 3 by yourself. You don't need their help. And as always, don't forget to ask any questions that you have in the comments below. Thank you so much for your time.